JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for November the 9th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD. I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all the other major currencies on Monday during the Asian session Tuesday, falling the most versus the pound, the yen, and the kiwi. Now, the weakening of the US dollar combined with the strengthening of the kiwi and the pound suggests that markets may have traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, the strengthening of the yen points otherwise. Therefore, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here we see that major European indices traded lower or unchanged, with the only exception being France's CAC 40, which gained somewhat. Later in the day, all of Wall Street's main indices closed positive, with sentiment staying relatively supported in Asia today as well. The only index finishing in the red was Japan's Nikkei 225. Now, European indices were dragged down by tech stocks, which may have come under selling interest after Tesla CEO Elon Musk said a Twitter poll asking whether he should sell about 10% of his stock holdings, with the poll attracting 3.5 million votes, 57.9% of which voted yes. The poll follows a proposal by US Senate Democrats to tax stocks of billionaires in an attempt to fill a loophole that allowed the rich to defer capital gains taxes. That said, although this weighed on the Tesla stock as well later in the US session, Wall Street inched north for another session, perhaps due to U.S. Congress passing President Biden's $1 trillion spending bill on Saturday. Now lawmakers turn to the social spending bill, which is expected to go under a House vote next week. Now, as for our view, with several central banks appearing less hawkish than expected recently, we would expect equities to continue drifting north. However, heading into Wednesday's US inflation data for October, we prefer to stay sidelined for now. Expectations are for both the headline and core CPI rates to have increased further, which could add to the view that the latest surge in inflation may not be transitory after all. This could encourage market participants to bring forth their expectations with regards to a rate hike by the Fed, and may result in a rebound in the US dollar. At the same time, equities could pull back, but we don't expect a long-lasting reversal. We believe that despite expectations over sooner and faster rate hikes, anything pointing to economic resilience could encourage more stock buying. After all, investors may have already digested the idea of higher rates soon. Now back to the currencies. The pound was the second best performing major currency, behind the Japanese yen, recovering a decent portion of last week's losses triggered by the Bank of England's decision not to hike interest rates and instead say that this could happen in coming months. Yesterday's rebound may have been the result of fresh comments by Governor Andrew Bailey, who said that they are on a path towards raising interest rates, something that may have may have revived expectations over a December move. However, we are reluctant to trust Bailey. Remember that a couple of weeks ahead of last week's gathering, he said that they have to act to contain inflation expectations, comments which encouraged market participants to price in an 80% chance of a hike at that meeting. We will rely more on the upcoming preliminary GDP data for the third quarter, due out on Thursday. Expectations are for a decent slowdown, which could revive speculation that a rate hike may eventually be delivered in the first months of the new year instead of December, and thereby result in a new negative wave in the pound. Now, as for today's events, in terms of data, the only worth mentioning is Germany's ZW survey for November. Both the current conditions and economic sentiment indices are expected to have declined somewhat to 18 and 20 from 21.6 and 22.3. This will be the sixth straight slide in the economic sentiment index and may add to concerns over how much Eurozone's growth engine has been affected by the latest bottlenecks. This will add credence to the ECB President Lagarde's view, who said that they don't see the conditions of a potential rate hike being met around the timing the market suggests. She will deliver a speech today, and we expect her to try and push back those expectations once again. And if she succeeds this time, the euro is likely to come under renewed selling pressure. Now, besides ECB's Lagarde, we will get to hear again from Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey, as well as by Fed Chair Jerome Powell. As for tonight, during the Asian session Wednesday, we have China's CPI and PPI for October. The CPI rate is forecast to have risen to 1.4% year over year from 0.7%, while the PPI is anticipated to have accelerated to 12.4% year over year from 10.7%. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So bye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.